A equals to KC, CAB, CAS. CAB, CAS ya. Ingat tak macam ni RA. This one KCA. Ingat tak? CA, CB kan CA, CA not minus CA. CA not minus CA. Kan? So this case, so dalam ni macam RA equals to KCA. So KC ini akan replace sebagai specific reaction rate kalau dia adalah mass transfer yang tu. K value. Faham eh? So untuk hari ni, what I want you to know is how you gonna develop your KC. Okay, KC, mass transfer. Untuk hari ni mesti boleh kira macam dia nak dapatkan KC. Sebab kalau you tak dapat KC, you cannot calculate your reactor size. You cannot estimate. So the first thing, kalau mass transfer, then you need to find your KC. Okay? Okay, dalam KC, so I dah ada simplified a little bit ni, ya. Yeah? Okay, nampak tak graph, nampak tak figure ni? Mana nak find your KC, mass transfer coefficient. Tadi tu dia ada delta kan? Kalau you bagi you ada delta, then your delta, kalau dia bagi delta, if you have delta, then to find your KC, you kena KC sama dengan DAB over delta. Okay? Kalau delta is not being given, then you need to check either porosity being given or not. Porosity tu apa? The arrangement, how packed the molecule or the species being arranged. Okay, in one certain volume. Okay, kalau porosity kadang boleh 10%, 20%, 50%, it depends kan. Kalau macam sponge, porosity tu lagi tinggi. Betul tak? So that will be kalau bagi porosity tu. So the arrangement tu kena tengok juga sebab kalau you terlalu dense, then you punya pressure drop akan tinggi. Tapi kalau you tak porosity sangat, dia tak dense, so dia lagi senang nak move. So itu lagi senang. Tapi you akan consume a lot of space. So dia ada macam drawbacks lah. You kena pandai-pandai lah. So kalau delta tak dibagi, tapi porosity pun dia tak bagi. So you kena guna Froehlich. Okay, please use your book. Make sure you ada buku you, okay? Buku you semua, yeah? Okay, porosity tu kita guna Froehlich. Sekejap, I buka buku I. Semua ada buku masing-masing. Ni buku ni kena tag, yeah? Siapa yang tak ada buku tu, kena download lah buku soft copy tu, yeah? Tentu chapter 11. Go to chapter 11. Okay, ke chapter 11 ke? Minus. Okay, the chapter 11, Okay, Froehlich tu, you kena tengok dekat, turn to page 776. Ada? Turn to page 776. Dalam 776, look at equation 11-40. Dapat tak?
Nampak.
Okay. So 11-40 tu, dia ada equation dia tu kan? Kan? Sherwood dah. Yang ni you kena effect juga lah. Sherwood number, Schmidt number, Reynolds number. Sherwood number SH ada dekat atas equation 11-38. Reynolds number, you need to go through equations. Dia ada Reynolds number dia. Okay, equation 11-31. Page 774. Buka buku buka buku. Yang ni tag dalam buku Okay, and then your Schmidt number tu dekat equation 11-39. All these equations are dimensionless. So kalau you kira, you make sure the unit tu should be cross each other.
Okay.
So kalau yang tu, so that will be your cross-link, cross-link correlation. Kalau porosity tak diberi, then you have to use cross-link correlation. Okay. Kalau yang delta tu, yang atas itu delta diberi, if delta is given, then you have to yes, kena yes, then you kena case it equals to DAB. So where to get your DAB tu? Okay, turn to page 770. Dapat eh?
Dapat, doktor.
Okay, look at table 11.2. Okay, that 11.2, table 11.2. Apa dia? Okay, situ ada diffusivity relationship between unit, you can find your DAB at different phase of species. If the species is in gas, ada bulk and Knudsen. Then dekat bawah tu ada liquid, ada solid. So DAB dia sangat berkait rapat dengan temperature and pressure. Sebab dia macam macam you bagi dia energy lah. Kalau you bagi dia more energy, so much easier untuk dia pass through. Kalau tak, nanti lagi lah sikit kan. So DAB ni akan mainkan peranan. So ada 11.2, table 11.2. So dia ada gas. Ada satu bulk, ada satu Knudsen. What's the difference between bulk and Knudsen? What's the difference between bulk and Knudsen?
Knudsen consider temperature je.
Okay, lagi?
Oh, lepas tu dia ada both liquid. Bukan. Tak tahu.
Okay, kalau consider bulk, maksudnya the gas phase tu is in bulk. Maksudnya banyak, high concentration. Tapi kalau Knudsen, it's very dilute condition. So bila dilute condition, that's why they only effect on temperature. Sebab dia sangat memerlukan tenaga. So you need to supply energy. That's why they effect on the temperature. So that would be Knudsen. Tapi kalau you bulk, maksudnya you high concentration, you banyak. Bulk kan banyak. Kan kalau bulk, so you need to use the equation bulk tu. Yang 10, equation atas tu. Kan ada DAB T2P2 tu kan? Kalau dia ada DAB T2P2, okay. You jangan darabkan tau. Yang itu dia kata DAB T2 and P2. Bukan darab eh. Jangan masukkan. Faham eh? So DAB T2P2 tu sama dengan DAB T1P1. Means that DAB at T2P2 equals to DAB T1P1. And then baru you multiply P1 dengan P2, T2 dengan T1. Faham eh? So yang ni is how gonna find your DAB. So let's say if delta is given, then you can use KC equals to DAB over delta, then you can get your DAB. Soalnya DAB kita berilah, tak ada lah you nak cari. Kan, so DAB kita bagi, so cuma kadang-kadang kita bagi you at different temperature. So in different temperature, in order for you to get the new DAB, then you need to use this equation, this table, 11.2. Type that page. Okay? Clear eh? Hari ni memang banyak guna buku, so you have to tag that page. The one that I said to you, the page I kena tag tu semua very important equation. Right? So that will be delta. If yes, then you have to use KC equals to DAB over delta. DAB, get the equation from table 11.2, page 770. If delta is not given, then you have to see either porosity is given or not. Dalam porosity, if it's not being given, porosity is not given, then you have to use cross-link correlation. Page 776, equation 1140. Then you need to know how to find your Schmidt number, Reynolds number and Sherwood number. And this number is all, semua this number ni semua adalah dimensionless. Dalam Sherwood number, look at equation 1138, the top one at page 776. You get you with me, yeah? Yeah, 1138, page 776, look at the equation, Sherwood number. That Sherwood number is equals to KC dP over DAB. So DAB is still applied. Okay, so that ada KC kat situ. So that Sherwood number will masukkan nanti DAB dengan dP tu, then you will get the KC from your Sherwood number, where your Sherwood number equals to 2 plus 0.6 Reynolds number power 1/2 and Schmidt number at power 1/3, equation 1140, page 776. Highlight that equation. Okay. If porosity is not given. And that's why kalau kan ada diamond shape tu kan. If no, then you have to use Frostling. Clear? Are you with me everyone?
Yes,
doctor.
Okay, good. Okay, good. Okay, the next part is if your porosity been given, porosity given, okay, means that adalah porosity you tu. So if that is the case, then you have to use Tonus and Kremers or Colburn J, either one. Tapi in order for you to use that thing, you need to see the condition. Dia ada assumption dia. Okay, now look at page 784, 785. Ada tak? Look at page 784, 785. Okay, look at equation 1165. 1165, that is equation of Tonus and Kremers. Ada one yang I cakap tu. Ada page 784 tu kan? Tonus and Kremers. This one porosity is being given. Tonus and Kremers only can be used if your porosity in between 0.25 till 0.5. Your Reynolds number, tengok Reynolds number dia tu ada apostrophe. Tadi yang Frostling tu dia tak ada apostrophe kan? Because yang Reynolds number apostrophe ni, dia because ada porosity. You can look at bawah dia tu, Reynolds number dia tu apa, Schmidt number dia tu pun apa. Semua dia ada, sebab dia ada apostrophe tu means that dia ada porosity tu. And look at the equation. So your Reynolds number should, you can be used Tonus and Kremers. If your porosity 0.25, 0.5, your Reynolds number from 40 to 4,000 and your Schmidt number between 1 to 4,000. These Tonus and Kremers only can apply if all the spec ni in line dengan you, comply dengan you punya ni, condition dia. Faham tak? So this one, you, equation tu daripada Sherwood number SH apostrophe tu, dia ada KCDP juga kan? So you can get the KC daripada the whole equation yang paling panjang ni. Remember, this is dimensionless. Make sure kalau unit tu selalunya meter, sentimeter, selalu tu sudah akan confuse lah tu. So make sure unit tu masuk betul-betul. In order for you to check whether you get the correct or not answer tu, you check. Boleh unit tu. Okay. So unit is very important. The good thing is about engineer, dia sangat particular dengan unit. So make sure unit tu dimensionless. So ini adalah untuk Sherwood Tonus and Kremers method. Okay, kalau dia tak comply either one of it, dia mesti comply tiga-tiga ni. Kalau tak comply, tak boleh guna. Kalau tak boleh guna, then you have to use Colburn J. In Colburn J, look at equation page 784 tu, equation 1168, bawah dia tu. Bottom pun ada Colburn J, nampak tak? That Colburn J, JD, kita panggil Colburn J, JD, equals to Sherwood number divided by Schmidt number about 1/3 and divided by Reynolds number. Tag that page, tag that page. Highlightkan that equation. That is a Colburn J equation. So this Colburn J equation, sometimes you can have the JD. So JD tu is like not constant. It's like another parameter for you to find. To find the JD, look at page 785. That page 785, look at equation 1169. That equation 1169, they can show you how to find your JD. JD you need to find by using Reynolds number. Kan nampak kan ni? Porosity JD equals to 0.765 divided by Reynolds number power of 0.82 plus 0.365 divided by Reynolds number 0.386. Okay, this JD is only can apply, dia ada relationship. Tengok ayat yang atas paragraph tu, dia kata it only can apply if your Reynolds number for gas for more than 10 and your liquid is more than 0.01. So that one you can be used. Clear? Boleh? So Renault jadi ada dia punya spek juga. So you kena tengok spek mana yang nak pakai. Kalau porosity ada, so you nak guna tonnage grammars or Colburn J. Tengok condition dia yang mana satu. Kalau boleh spek tonnage grammars, then you have to use tonnage grammars. Kalau Colburn J, then you have to use Colburn J. Faham eh? Boleh? Itu cara nak kira dia. Boleh ke tak boleh?
Boleh doktor.
Okay, good.
Maksudnya doktor guna salah satu yang ada maklumat lah doktor.
Yes. Guna salah satu.
Kalau
tapi
yang...
dengan syarat porosity adalah.
Oh, okay.
Apa dia? Tanyalah lagi soalan. Yang gambar yang saya tunjuk kat you ni, I just baru buat sebab biasanya I akan tulis dekat papan hitam tapi hari ni tak ada kan. So I just tulis kat situ so that ni. Yang ni sangat penting. Okay, sebabnya biasanya kan outcome you kena design, betul tak? Design reactor. Tapi kalau you nak design reactor, kalau mass transfer control, you need to find your KC sebab KC sekarang ni is the one that control the reaction. K ni, KC ni akan replace your K. That's why you need to find your KC dulu. Kalau tak ada KC memang susah lah you nak ni. You nak do the design of your reactor. Kan? Macam masa chapter 1, we ask you to find what mechanism apa semua in order for us to find one rate law. So this rate law can be used to design your reactor. So in mass transfer effect, so you need to find your KC in order for you to design your reactor because KC will control the, because mass transfer control, so KC yang dominant compared to K specific reaction tu, KR, kita panggil KR lah specific reaction, KR. Faham eh? So untuk hari ini, we want you to find your KC. Saya tak dapat lah tengok macam mana you nak buat, saya tak boleh nak tolong you macam mana buat calculation. Okay? Biasanya in class, I ask you to sit in group. So I will divide you into two groups. One will be under Tonnage Grammars, another one is on Colburn J. So if I were you, in your case, you dah tahu siapa duduk dalam group you kan? So you set up, bahagikan dua pun boleh ataupun kalau you rajin, you buat dua-dua pun tak apa. So look at example 11.3, page 785. Ada tak?
Ada doktor.
Okay, good. 11.3 yang 7.5 tu kat situ dia ada macam-macam equation kan? Bukan equation lah, dia bagi saya condition. You jangan tengok macam mana nak design tu. Yang X equation 1131 tu, tu dah design equation. Nanti saya akan ajar you macam mana nak buat design equation. Untuk hari ni, you need to find how to find the KC sahaja, objektif. Yang lain selalu saya cakap dalam kelas. You come to my class, make sure you learn something new. So in this case, you come to my class today and you should be able to find your KC. Okay? So in fact, to find KC, you ada tengok ada tonnage grammars, ada part tonnage grammars, part A, ada part B on Colburn J, Colburn J part B. So dua-dua ni dia akan bagi jawapan yang slightly berbeza, slightly berbeza tengok pada keadaan. Cuma bila I minta you tolong buat balik yang ni, sebab dalam ni dia ada different sedikit cara nak kira. So kalau macam Colburn, Tonnage and Grammars part A tu, dia ada step nombor satu sampai, okay you buat yang ini dia memang dah siap so untuk you redo balik that exercise. Kalau I bagi yang baru, tiba-tiba kan you pening sikit. So kita dah ada yang ni, you try to redo balik. Sebab especially student bila tak tahu macam mana nak dapatkan Renault number, Sherwood number, benda semua tu. So yang ni yang penting. So antara A, yang part A tu sampai equation yang dapatkan KC, example E11-3.7. Yang tu sampai situ je. Yang bawah tu jangan tengok dulu. Yang tu ada design question. Tu tak payah tengok dulu. Kita nak dapatkan KC sahaja. So ada dua method. Satu Tonnage Grammar, satu Colburn J. Okay, look at. Okay, kalau you tengok Tonnage and Grammar sebelum saya terlupa Sebelum you tengok Tonnage and Grammar, dia ada DP. Tonnage and Grammar muka surat 784. Dapat tak? Saya tak guna slide Sebab saya selalu chapter ni saya tak guna slide sangat. Selalu saya ni. You dapat tak DP? Turn to page 784. Tonnage and Grammars ada DP kat situ.
Ya.
So dalam DP yang tu ada tak dia kata particle diameter, ya, yeah, DP tu. Dia bukan diameter of the catalyst lagi tau. Dia dah lain. Dia dah kena kira lain sedikit. So DP yang tu ialah particle diameter equivalent diameter of sphere at the same volume. Eh, sama tu 6 over pi times dengan volume of pellet. So dalam ni, shape of the catalyst is very important. Shape. Sama ada dia sphere ke, dia silinder ke, dia pellet ke, ataupun dia slab ke, pun semua boleh. Bukan semua boleh, maksudnya you kena tahu macam mana nak dapatkan how to get the volume of a shape catalyst. Ha, ya? Kalau catalyst tu silinder, macam mana nak dapatkan volume of silinder? Macam mana dapatkan? Pi R squared L kan, height dia ataupun height dia kan, so dia dapatkan volume dia, ingat surface area times height, so macam tu. So you kena tahu macam mana nak tahukan shape of the catalyst. So kalau dalam ni DP dia bagi kalau macam sphere, sphere. Kalau dalam exam, dalam test, kalau dia tak bagi should ask, kalau dia tak know juga, you assume sphere. Okay? Okay, lepas tu tengok kalau Qantas and Kramers, you tengok ada macam gamma tu, shape factor. Tengok tak shape factor bawah tu. Macam gamma sikit. Ada tak? Dekat Qantas and Kramers, muka surat 784. Dekat bawah void fraction tu, ada satu shape macam gamma. Ada tak?
Ada shape factor.
Yang shape factor tu. So this shape factor is actually sama dengan external surface area divided by pi dp. So you dapatkan dp yang ke atas ni, then baru you boleh dapatkan ni. So you kena bahagi. So external surface area. That's why I kata you punya surface area tu very, bukan surface area, shape of the catalyst tu very important. You need to find the area of the catalyst. Satu catalyst tu berapa area dia tu. So you kena tahu yang tu. Faham eh? External surface area. So catalyst tu, kalau satu catalyst tu berapa keluasan tu you kena kira. So that's why kena tahu apa dia punya catalyst tu punya shape. Clear eh? So kalau ni, so that's why I said you need to try Tonus and Kramers. Colburn J pun ada juga dia punya method dia. Colburn J pun sama juga. Dia area over DP tu. You kena tengok. Colburn J cara DP dia tak sama dengan dengan Tonus and Kramers. Dia lain sedikit. So in this case, I will advise you, some of you may do Tonus and Kramers, some of you may use Colburn J. Kita buat exercise ni boleh tak hari ni? On a piece of paper.
Boleh.
So you buat on piece of paper, you buat this exercise. Sampai dapat example ni, sampai dapatkan nilai KC.